आई जस्ट आस्क योर मिस वर्क ऑफ द फर्स्ट चैप्टर, दैट इज आई मीन ओनली आई हैव सेंड देयर. टीचिंग यू साइंस, वट मीनिंग इज देयर इन इंग्लिश. आई थिंक सो. क्वेश्चन आंसर एंड एक्सरसाइजेस ऑफ द बुक we have done. You have done and it's checked also. Chapter 5 are done, covered. Of in science, in science, so now I'm teaching you second chapter. So here, what are communicable diseases and how they spread? We just now discussed. You people are not responding at all. I don't know if you are understood or not. Yes, Sabah, you tell me the way through which this communicable diseases is spread. Yes. Your previous teacher is giving, so you must have to do. Anyway, so let's move. Yes. Yes, yes, one at a time, one at a time. Hiba Rahman, you tell me. Yes. Okay. So, communicable disease and through which the ways they are, what you can say, spread from one person to another, we discussed in this class. Here some examples are given that by using the handkerchief of the unhealthy or the diseased person, the disease can be spread. And if we eat the food, means the dirty food, the uncovered food, that also, what you can say, cause the disease. In the same way, means a person is sitting in this picture, the shivering from shivering, and that's because of the malaria. Now this on the page number 28, there's a table 2.3, some communicable diseases. So here is the table of communicable diseases, common cold. So the common cold symptoms are cough, sore throat, running nose, and fever. So they are the symptoms of the common cold and how it can be prevented. So it can be prevented by regular hand washing and keeping away from the infected person. Common cold can be means a person can be prevented or to be safe by keeping away from this infected person and regularly hand wash, means before eating anything, we should wash our hand. If any sort of infection is there in hand, then that can be removed by washing it. Then another disease is pneumonia. Pneumonia symptom is cough, fever, shaking, chill, and shortness of breath. So shortness of breath or shaking chill and cough and fever. These are the symptoms and they can be treated or the prevent by using the antibiotics. What is antibiotic? Antibiotics are actually the substances that kills the disease causing germs. Means that kill the germs. That kill the microorganism which causes disease. Antibiotics are the substances which kill the pathogen, which kill the or germs or disease causing microorganism, you can say. So this is the substance that kills the germs. So by giving the antibiotic, we can be prevented from the pneumonia. Then tuberculosis, the symptoms are fevers, chill, night sweat, loss of appetite, weight loss, weakness, continued cough and chest pain. These are the symptoms when someone is suffering from tuberculosis. These symptoms will be visible, and that can be treated with by using the antibiotics. And antibiotics, just now I told you, they are the substances which kills the germ or disease causing microorganisms. So now just raise your hand. What are the symptoms of common cold? Raise your hand. हमना काशिफ, यस बेटा, हमना काशिफ, व्हाट आर द सिम्टम ऑफ कॉमन कोल्ड? वेरी गुड, माशाल्लाह. Okay, Afia Inam, you tell me the preventive measures of common cold. Very good, mashallah. Now, Rushda, you tell me symptoms of pneumonia. Very good. Now, Eraz. Tell me the preventive measures of pneumonia. Eraz. Tell me the preventive measures of pneumonia. Yes. Were you there in the class only when I was teaching you? Did you not listen what I explained? Imad Ahmed, you tell me. Imad Ahmed, yes, you tell me. I asked the preventive measures of the pneumonia. Means by using the antibiotics. And Mohammed Uzair, you tell me, what are antibiotics? What are antibiotics? And Mohammed Uzair, okay, you tell me what are antibiotics. That's good. Now, Maryam Mirza. टेल मी द सिम्टम ऑफ ट्यूबरक्लोसिस मरियम में. सिम्टम्स ऑफ ट्यूबरक्लोसिस. सिम्टम्स ऑफ ट्यूबरक्लोसिस क्विकली. यस यस. Afia, you tell me symptoms of the tuberculosis. Very good, mashallah. So the symptom of tuberculosis: fever, chills, night sweat, loss of appetite, weight loss, weakness, continued cough, chest pain. These can be the symptom of the tuberculosis. Now, yes, Mohammad Uzair. Yes, Mohammad Uzair. Tell me the preventive measure of tuberculosis. Tell me the preventive measures of tuberculosis. And what are the antibiotics? Yes. Antibiotics. What are antibiotics, Rushda? Yes, substances. Actually, antibiotics are the substances which kills the disease-causing organism, which kills the germs, which kills the pathogen. Got it? Very good. So now let's start preventive communicable diseases. Means how can we prevent communicable diseases? So communicable diseases can be prevented by maintaining good personal and community hygiene. As we know that they are means like spread or the caused by the germs only. So if we keep ourselves clean and our surrounding clean, we can be safe from so many diseases. That's why cleanliness is half of iman. It means half of the iman is we can keep safe by keeping ourselves clean and our surrounding clean. Why? Because keeping ourselves clean and surrounding clean can keep us healthy. So that's why it means we can get reward also if we keep ourselves clean, our surrounding clean. So hygiene may be defined as practices that help to ensure cleanliness and good health. Means what is hygiene? Hygiene actually all the practices. Yes, actually hygiene is all the practices, all the activities you can say to ensure the cleanliness or good health. Means for keeping us clean, we bathe, we brush our teeth, we rinse our mouth, we wash our hand before every eating, we wear clean clothes, we keep our surroundings clean. These all practices comes under the hygiene. Means these all practices are called hygiene. So for these there are some steps to maintain good hygiene. Means how one can maintain the good hygiene. So there are some points regarding it, that we should eat clean and healthy food. We should not eat uncovered food from a roadside vendors. as I told you that the uncovered food attracts the animals, small animals or the insects. And insects are the carrier of disease-causing organisms. They carry the disease-causing organisms or the germs. So insects are actually, they are the carrier of the germs. So if you keep the food uncovered, insects are come and sit on it and they leave the germs there. As a result, the food is contaminated and someone will eat this contaminated or dirty food, then will be diseased only. So we should not eat uncovered food, especially the roadside vendors. If they are having the food uncovered on their stalls, so we should not eat the uncovered food. That is unhealthy, that can cause diseases. So we should eat healthy food. And next point, we wash our hand before and after eating means like that sunnah also. If we wash our hand before and after eating, that's not keep only ourselves healthy. That because of that we get a lot of reward also, because it's sunnah. We get the reward because of following sunnah. So that's very important, that we should wash our hand before and after eating. Before eating, it's okay means like when we wash our hand before eating, that means we save us from getting the food contaminated with the germs which is present in the hand. But why we are washing after eating? Can anyone tell, raise your hand, why we are washing our hand after eating? Before eating, though, means when we eat with the dirty hand, the germs will go inside the body, and that can cause disease. But why we wash hand after eating? Can anyone tell? Yes, here are some hands raised. Yes, Aisha Iqbal, why you wash hand after eating? Yes. One reason is that the food, the hand gets dirty, and means that the food is stuck on the hands. They just invite the insects or the germs. Germs, you know, they cause diseases. So to avoid this, we should wash our hand, and it's sunnah also. Means on washing our hand, we get the rewards. Okay. And then we should not drink unclean water. Drinking water should be kept in clean and covered utensils. We should brush our teeth, we should bathe daily, we should rinse our mouth each and every meal. We should eat in the clean utensils. We should not allow water to collect in and around our house. Like in outside the houses, the water is collected in some, means what you can say, the pits are there, the water is collected, or the drains also, or sometimes, you know, the broken substances are there on the roadside, and there also water collected. So we should avoid this, because these are the places where the mosquito breed. They just increased because of this stagnant water. Stagnant water is actually the water which is just not moving. It just is stored on a place, and because of that, it's not moving. The foul smell is coming. The bad smells come from it. And of course, we should keep ourselves and our surrounding clean. How we can keep our surrounding clean? By throwing the garbage in the dustbin, and we should not allow garbage to collect in dump. So these are the few things which we follow, so we can be safe ourselves from many diseases. And of course, if someone is infected, someone is diseased, we try to be away from the infected person, because it can be spread from the direct contact as well. and some of the communicable diseases can be prevented by vaccination as well. Vaccination is actually the use of special substances. Means in vaccination, we use special substance that is called vaccine. Vaccine is actually a specific substance that prevent from the diseases. And why we take vaccine? Vaccine is actually build the resistance in the body, means increase the immunity. Vaccine are actually the dead or the weakened germs only. Like suppose some disease is caused by the virus. So vaccine is actually made up of the weakened or the killed viruses of the same disease. And that is introduced in the body. And why we introducing in the body means like when body is having the defense system, our body is having a defense system means when they see any sort of foreign bodies or the germs or you can say harmful element, then the body start preparing the chemicals to fight with those germs. So when we introduce weak and killed germs in the body, weak and killed germs, they cannot cause disease in the body because they are very weak. If they are killed, then how they can cause disease? So they cannot cause disease in the body, but body recognize those germs, and as a result, body is ready with the chemical to fight with it. So vaccine is actually the same microbe that is weakened or the killed. It is introduced in the body, and we introduce a vaccine in the body to build the resistance or for increasing the immunity. So by some of the communicable diseases can be prevented by vaccination also. So some of the vaccines are given at to the children in very young stage of young age to prevent from some many diseases. So here our chapter is completed. Time is also over, and just ending.